go.
Good morning, Eisenhower. Today is Martin Luther King Day, Monday, January 16th, 2012, Day B. We're your host,
Brian
and Charlie.
For those of you who don't know, Martin Luther King Jr. was an American clergyman, activist, and prominent leader in the African American civil rights movement. He is best known for being an iconic figure in the advancement of civil rights in the United States and around the world using nonviolent methods. King has become a national icon in the history of modern American liberalism. Please rise for the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
You may be seated. Now for today's announcements with Taylor and Cameron.
Good morning, I'm Cameron.
Along with Taylor. What does today's weather look like?
Today, sunny. Highs in the low 30s. Northwest winds around 5 miles per hour, becoming south with gusts up to 20 miles per hour this afternoon. Tonight, snow, sleet, rain, likely with the chance of freezing rain in the evening, then sleet, freezing rain, and rain after midnight. Little or no snow and sleet accumulation. Tomorrow, rain, high in the mid-40s, southwest winds 5 to 10 miles per hour, chance of rain 90%. Now here's Taylor with the rest of the today's announcements.
Attention 7th graders, there is a canteen this Friday, January 20th, from 7:30 p.m. to 9:30 p.m. Doors open at 7:20 p.m. and no early admittance permitted. There will be jousting, a DJ, guitar hero, and games. Socialize with friends, dance, and have fun. Please bring non-perishable canned or boxed goods to be donated to local charity. A raffle ticket will be given for each item donated. There will be 3 gift card raffles. Remember to bring your student ID. If you have not yet registered, your parent or guardian must come in with you to sign the registration form and pay. Attention 8th graders, the time has come to get together, get dressed up, and celebrate being the top of the school at the 8th grade semi-formal dance, Friday, February 3rd from 7:30 to 10. The invitation should be handed out today during homeroom. Do you want a yearbook in June? If you do, you must purchase one now through the yearbook company. Mailings have been sent to your houses with information on how to order one. We do not sell them through the school. Our orders are really down this year. So far, we have only sold 269 yearbooks, and that means only 269 students out of 830 students will be getting a yearbook in June. We have extended the deadline for ordering until February 1st. Go home and check with your parents to see if they have ordered a yearbook. If they haven't, tell them to do so by February 1st. Don't be left out in all the fun the yearbook provides in June. It is great to have all your friends autograph your yearbook, but first you need to buy one. If you have any questions, please see Ms. Sloan in the library. Here's Cameron with the rest of the day's announcements.
Thank you, Taylor. Student Council is having a snack and water sale today during lunch periods. Bring small bills if you're interested in purchasing. Remember, it's a minimum day, so there's no lunch in the cafeteria. REACT is having a bagel breakfast on Thursday, January 19th at 7:40 a.m. Come in from the cold and join us for bagels and juice. Bagels are $1 and juice is 50 cents. All proceeds will go to charity. If you would like a DVD of the winter concert, download an order form from the Eisenhower website. DVDs are $5 each. Are we celebrating any birthdays?
Eisenhower wishes a very happy birthday to Sam, Cameron in 7K and Brandon in 7H. What's for lunch today?
We do not have any lunch today. Today is a minimum day. What's Monday? What's tomorrow's lunch?
Tomorrow's lunch is taco boat with cheese, lettuce, and tomato. What's in the headlines?
John M. Huntsman Jr. will announce today that he is ending his bid for the Republican presidential nomination and endorsing Mitt Romney. And now back to our host, Charlie and Ryan.
Thanks, Taylor and Cameron. And now for today's feature with Aaron and Monica.
Thanks, Charlie and Ryan.
Today is Martin Luther King Day. On 3R's Day, we learned about respect and responsibility. Martin Luther King had a passion for helping others and human rights.
In tradition of Martin Luther King Day, Wesley Autry risked his own life to help save a man who fell on the train tracks. Let's find out more about Wesley Autry.
Thousands of people ride the subway every day while waiting like everyone else. Wesley Autry became a hero. When a man fell on the subway after having a seizure, Autry didn't think twice about helping him. He saved an innocent life that day and inspired the minds of millions.
Turnstile, I noticed a young man fall flat on his back, hands, legs, feet kicking and shaking. And I literally said, there's a problem. Somebody having a seizure or something. So I asked him, keep calling the police or the paramedic. Me and my two daughters proceeded on. And as we got past him, I looked down and noticed the young man who was choking. He was gagging. He was sweating. So I was like, oh, you know, when you were on the tracks and the trains coming this way and down. So my daughter's looking at me out of amazement. And I was like, yeah, we want to first aid CPR.
Autry put his life at risk to save someone else's, not caring if it was videotaped.
I kneeled down on my right knee and I got him leaning up against my left leg by his weight. My leg kept shifting back and forth and I couldn't really hold him still and perform CPR right. So I pried his mouth open and I asked one of the ladies for a camera. The reason why our camera's breathing was a little erratic, the camera was falling his tongue. So I stuck the pin in his mouth and brought the pin forward. His breathing came back to normal. Eyes stopped blurring and looked at my two girls, let him go and get something he walks away about 10 or 15 feet. When you're not getting the right amount of flow of oxygen to your brain, it throws your coordination, your balance, and everything off. And when he walked away, he was stunned and staggering, so his right shoulder hit one of the subway poles in the subway. That caused him to spun around. When he spun around, his footing got crisscrossed. Trying to unlock his foot, still at the same time, his coordination, his balance, everything was still off. He was trying to unlock his leg, and he fell off the platform backwards. And as he was landing, he fell back this way, and with the train coming in, that the train dipped sometime, it come from behind the station, and around. And as he landed across the track, one arm on one track, and there was another leg on another. Another season, and I looked back and I saw the two ladies. I looked down at the camera and I looked back at the two ladies that pointed. And once I made sure that my girls were safe, I got off the platform and stopped running to one camera and I jumped onto the tracks to save them.
Wesley Autry performed something most people would be too scared to even act on. Even though Autry doesn't think he was a hero to the life he saved on January 2nd, 2007.
That was a very inspirational feature. Features coming up this week are Wyckoff football and Mr. Gutierrez's class's Spanish commercials. And now back to our hosts, Charlie
and Ryan.
Thanks, Aaron and Monica. Ryan, I got a good joke for you, and I won't bet you won't get it. What's a cat's favorite treat?
Ice cream.
Thanks for watching, Eisenhower. Have a Martin Luther King Jr. Monday.